If you want to understand capitalism, you have to read Marx, whatever your politics, because no one else has explained the logic and the functioning of the capitalist system as well as Marx had. He was talking already in the 19th century about the financialization that we have witnessed and referring to it as zombie capitalism, dead capitalism, which feeds on itself, which doesn't create anything. And that is neoliberal capitalism. That is the capitalism which Fernando Henrique Cardoso brought into this country, destroyed what was being created, and created these financialized networks. Bring your money in, you can earn money, all this sort of stuff. You have to go to Marx to find that. You know, I'm not saying other people haven't said it subsequently, but it's very interesting reading Marx, and while some parts of, you know, his, where he goes into economic details can be a bit taxing and difficult, a lot of the stuff is written very beautifully, using lots of references from literature and world literature, from Goethe, from Shakespeare, to explain how the system functions. And that, I think, is it's extremely important. You will never be bored if you read that. That's a word of advice, and many of the economists who are working today will learn a great deal from him if they decided to, you know, just write a bit better. So I think it's important. The second thing is Marx's political writings. Many people think of Marx simply as an economist. As a political journalist and a political columnist, he was wonderful. He knew immediately, as an analyst, what was the central problem. And he would write 4,000 words, 3,000 words, analyzing it. And people have forgotten that Marx was a correspondent in Europe for the New York Tribune and wrote many, many short articles. And these are just worth studying, like those of other people, because they are very interesting. And his political writings analyzing France and other countries in the mid-19th century, which we have just republished in verso in three volumes, are really wonderful. So I hope that people are reading him again. I think after Eric is right, after the crisis, lots of people went back and said, oh my God, This guy had actually predicted these things. And Marx, you know, was right when he wrote that capitalism is a process which will never be free of cyclical crises. And I often say to people who attack socialism that socialism only failed once. And you say it's dead, whereas capitalism has failed 30 times in its entire history, and yet you revive it. And we need to revive a new form of socialism, where we learn from the previous mistakes that have been made.